kid, what are you supposed to be? Obviously, I'm a doctor of storytelling. Is that even a thing? Storytelling is an art and a science. Are you telling me that you're some kind of a doctor now? I'm ignoring you now. Very sus. You know, I know that you are used to seeing women in the world who are doctors and scientists. They go into outer space. They're explorers. But once upon a time, women were told, you cannot do that. Preposterous! Outrageous! Yet true, women were not allowed in most universities, especially the programs that taught science and medicine, even law.
Unbelievable! Nonsensical!
But true. So when you hear about famous scientists of the world, you usually hear about men. But not today, because today we have women in science who changed the world.
Something doesn't make sense.
What, Cowboy Green Bear?
If women couldn't study science, how did they get to become scientists? Yeah, especially the world-changing kind.
Well, bears, where there's a will, there's a way.
I don't get it.
Okay, Red Bear, let me put it this way. You know how Green Bear is not allowed to eat cookies before dinner?
Yeah!
But somehow, he always manages to eat the cookies before dinner anyway?
Yeah, he wants them so bad that he finds a way. Oh, I think I just figured it out.
Mm-hmm.
When you really want something, you find a way to make it happen.
Where there's a will, there's a way.
I don't know what either of you are talking about.
Now, let's see what incredible things these women in science did, despite all the no's in the way. We begin with Maria Sibylla Merian, an entomologist. That is somebody who studies bugs. And Maria loved bugs. In my youth, I spent my time investigating insects, crawling through gardens, fields, and rainforests. Maria gathered all the bugs she could find. She watched each one and wondered, what will it do? Her observations taught her things that no one else knew yet. For example, how flies were not born from rotten fruit, which was one thing that they thought back then. And that caterpillars actually transform into butterflies. Maria's notes and drawings showed the world some of nature's tiniest miracles.
But, Storyteller, everyone in my class was taught that caterpillars turn into butterflies. We all know that.
Aha! But someone had to be the first to discover it.
Wow! Good job, Maria!
Wang Zhenyi, astronomer. Are you not convinced daughters can also be heroic? Zhenyi lived when most girls weren't allowed to study science, yet she loved to learn about the sun, the moon, and the stars, which is the study of astronomy. She watched as the moon disappeared into the shadow of the earth. People said it was angry gods, but Zhenyi thought there might be another explanation. She strung up a globe, a mirror, and a lamp by ropes in her house to learn more about how lunar eclipses worked, and she taught others what she found. Lunar eclipses, when the moon seems to vanish in the sky. But it was not angry gods, as people thought. She figured out the science behind the magic. Mary Anning, paleontologist. Oh, that is a scientist who likes to find and study the fossils of my ancestors. That is correct, Doug the dinosaur. And she said, did you know I had a dog named Trey who liked to go on expeditions with me? Arf, arf. Mary's father showed her how to explore the seaside cliffs of England after a storm. Now, mud often slid away to reveal hidden treasures. One day, Mary found a bony face in the mud. A bony face in the mud! Dun, dun, dun! When she chipped away the dirt, she found fossilized ribs, a spine, and legs. It was the world's first complete plesiosaurus skeleton. Mary kept searching for, sketching, and studying fossils, and her discoveries helped other scientists learn more about dinosaurs. And to find the complete skeleton of any dinosaur is considered the gold standard. Marie Curie, physicist and chemist.
And French, ooh la la.
Nothing in life is to be feared. It is only to be understood. Marie was curious about elements, substances found naturally in the earth. While studying pitch blend.
Pitch blend?
Uh-huh.
That's not ringing any bells.
Well, I was today years old when I learned that pitch blend is a radioactive, uranium-rich mineral and rock, also known as uraninite. See? Never stop learning. So, she was studying pitch blend when she discovered two new elements hidden within the pitch blend. Marie named these elements radium and polonium. Through experiments, Marie learned how X-rays could help injured soldiers. That's right, her discoveries of these elements led to X-rays, and they were helping injured soldiers. She also studied how radiation could help people with cancer. Marie was the first person ever to win two Nobel Prizes and was voted in 2009, long after she had left the Earth, as the most inspirational woman in science. Janaki Amal. She was a botanist, someone who loves learning about how plants and flowers grow. I am a born wanderer. There is a great restlessness in me. Ah, yes, a great restlessness is the hallmark of so many pioneering people who just want to know more. Now, Janaki was from India, and her country, India, had a problem with its sugar. It wasn't sweet.
That's a huge problem!
Right? Not sweet sugar? What's the point? The people had to bring in sugarcane from elsewhere, which could be expensive. Janaki studied the plant and created a new sweet sugarcane that could thrive in India. She wrote a book about thousands of plants and talked about ways to preserve India's plant life. And that book that she wrote back in 1940 is still considered essential for botany.
And I do believe she was the first female botanist in all of India.
Right you are, Farrah Fox. Katherine Johnson, mathematician. I asked questions. I wanted to know why. From the time Katherine was little, she was curious about numbers. She was so smart. Get this. She was so smart that she started high school when she was only 10 years old. Wow. What a brain, right? After finishing school, Katherine went to work for the country's space program, NASA. She made sure all the equations were right to send the first man in orbit around the Earth. And Katherine also helped calculate the path for the first rocket to the moon. And this was before computers. All that math she did, up here.
First rocket to the moon, you say?
I do say.
I suppose now you're gonna make some kind of a joke about how her accomplishments are out of this world.
Well, I don't have to because you already said it for me.
Ugh.
And I'm over the moon about it.
Ugh, how did you do that?
I'm a doctor of storytelling. That's how. Jane Cook Wright, oncologist. Those are the doctors that specialize in beating cancer. Work hard, persevere, collaborate with one another, be pioneers in the field, and keep up the good fight. Collaborate with one another. In case you don't know, that's a big, beautiful word that means work together. Jane wanted to be a doctor, just like her father, and she decided to study cancer because it was a disease that made so many people sick without a way to get better. Jane worked hard and discovered new medicines that would fight cancer. She wrote more than 100 papers about how to treat the disease, and that helped other doctors who would read the papers and know how to treat their patients. So many lives were saved. Because of Jane's research, doctors all over the world learned how they could help sick people get well again. And fun fact, they called her the mother of chemotherapy for the incredible treatments that she pioneered that are still in use today, decades and decades later. Jane Goodall, famous primatologist and conservationist. Primatologist, a scientist who studies primates, you know, monkeys, gorillas, apes, oh my! What you do makes a difference, and you have to decide what kind of difference you want to make. That's a really good thought. Jane did not study in a laboratory, oh no. She studied in the trees. Jane lived in Africa alongside her favorite animals, chimpanzees. She waited and watched and wrote down everything she learned. And thanks to Jane's observations, we understand that chimps can use tools and feel emotions like sadness or love, just like us. Today, Jane teaches others about the importance of protecting all living things. These scientists were brave enough to solve problems and give knowledge to the world. They weren't afraid of being the only ones in their fields.
They weren't stopped by all the no's they got.
Because they had a vision and a purpose. And what was that saying?
Where there's a will, there's a way, partner.
So you block out the no's, focus on your life's mission, and you too, just like these women of science, will make the world better.